Hi friends, I am continuing the problems on surface areas and volumes. Now, yesterday we did one problem. In the previous video, we did one problem and I gave one more problem to you to try. That problem is like this. I had drawn a sketch here. It's a right circular cone. This was the problem. Now here it is cut and this is removed, so it becomes a frustum of a cone. Now this height was given as 20 centimeters. This is 20 centimeters. The radius is 12 centimeter radius here. This we can call as R1. Here the radius is 3 centimeters, and this is the center axis, the axis of the cone. Now he says, after this is removed, a cone is having its base radius of 12 centimeters and height 20 centimeters. If the top of this cone is cut to form a small cone, base radius 3 centimeters is removed. This is removed. Then the remaining part of the solid cone becomes a frustum. Calculate the volume of the frustum, he says. Right. Calculate the volume of the frustum here. Now, to calculate the volume of the frustum, the formula is V is equal to 1 by 3 pi h into R1 square plus R2 square plus R1 R2. This is the formula for the volume of a frustum of a cone, right? Now here we know R1 is 12 centimeter, R2 is 3 centimeters, but we don't know H. H is from here to here, this height. This height we require to find out the volume. This height we require. Now, he calls this point as A, this point as O, this point as O dash, this point as C, I think this point is B. Now, here you have two triangles, AOC. AOC is one triangle and AOB is another triangle. Right, two right angle triangles. It's like this. This is C. This is C. Here you have O dash and B, let us say that is B. Now, triangle AOC and triangle AO dash B, they are similar triangles because this angle is equal to this angle, this angle is equal to this angle, and this is a common angle to both the triangles. A is common. So, they are similar triangles. If they are similar triangles, you see O dash B by OC must be equal to AO dash by AO, because these two triangles are similar. This we will get. So we can find out this AO dash. AO dash will be equal to O dash B into AO divided by OC. Now O dash B means O dash B is 3 into AO is 20 divided by OC is 12. So 3 ones are 3, 3 2, 3 4s are 12, 4 ones are 4, 5, 4 5s are 20, so it will be 5. Which will be 5? AO dash will be 5. AO dash will be 5. This H will be equal to 20 minus 5. That is 15 centimeters. That is from here to here it is, from here to here it is 15 centimeter. This is 15 and the upper part is 5 centimeter. So it will be 15 centimeter. Now we can use that formula and get the answer. So now it will be, I can substitute that value in the formula. V is equal to 1 by 3 into 22 by 7 into H is 15 into R1 square. R1 is 12 square plus R2 square is 3 square plus 12 into 3. This is the formula. So 1 by 3 into 22 by 7 into 15 into, this becomes 144 plus 9 plus 36. I think this is 1 by 3 into 22 by 7 into 15 into 144 plus 9 is 153. 153 plus 36 is 189. So 3 ones are 3, 3 6 are 18, 3 threes are 9, 7 nines are 7 ones are 7 nines are 63. So it becomes 22 into 15 into 9. 22 into 15 is 330 into 9. 900, 9 threes are 27, 2, 27 plus 9, 29. So it will be 2970 cubic centimeter cc. This is the volume of the frustum of the cone. So you will have to do like this. This carries 3 marks. 3 marks. There are some smaller problems also in this. We'll do that. Here, I see this is for 2 marks, I think. Yes. A metallic sphere of radius 9 centimeter. A metallic sphere of radius 9 centimeter is melted and recast into the shape of a cylinder of radius 6 centimeters. Find the height of the cylinder, he says. Find the height of the cylinder. Now, the problem is like this. We have a metallic sphere of radius 9 centimeter. It is melted down. It is melted, it becomes liquid. Then it is recast into a cylinder. Now, the cylinder has a radius of, this has a radius of 6 centimeters. 6 centimeters. 6 centimeters. So what is the height? What is H? Now, here, volume of cylinder is equal to volume of sphere. Because whatever material we have molded here, we have made it into a cylinder. So volume of cylinder will be pi. I will call this as R1 and this as R2. Now, volume of cylinder will be pi r2 square, that is area into height, this I don't know, h, is equal to, this is 4 by 3 pi r cube, pi r1 cube. I have taken r1 as the radius of the sphere, r2 as the radius of the cylinder. Now here this pi gets cancelled. Now h, I want h, this height of the cylinder will be equal to 4 by 3 into r1 cube by r2 square, r1 cube, r1 cube by r2 square, that is 4 by 3 into r1 is 9, so 9 into 9 into 9, 9 cube, divided by r2 square is 6 into 6. So now 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. This 2 gets cancelled. Everything in the denominator gets cancelled. Now what will be left here is 3 into 9. 3 into 9, that will be 27 centimeters. That is, the height of this cylinder will be 27 centimeters. That's it. Next, one more. The faces of two cubes. The faces of two cubes. Two cubes of volume 64 centimeter, cubic centimeter each are joined together to form a cuboid. Find the total surface area of the cuboid. Now, we have two cubes. Two identical cubes. Identical cubes. This is one cube. Its volume is 64 cc. We have one more cube whose volume is also 64 cc. 64 cc. This also is 64 cc. They are joined like this to form a cuboid. It gets you, you get a cuboid. See, now the volume of cuboid, volume of cube is a cube, side cube. So volume of cube is given 64 cc, so is equal to a cube. Therefore, side of the cube, side of the cube will be cube root of 64, that is 4 centimeters. Cube root of 64. 64 will be equal to 4 into 4 into 4. So cube root of 64 will be 4 centimeters. 4 fours are 16. 16 fours are 64. So this is, all the sides are 4 centimeters here. This is also 4, this is also 4, this is also 4, this is also 4, this is also 4. All the sides are 4. Now, when we join two cubes like this, this side, it will become 8. 8 centimeters, 4 plus 4, 8 centimeters. This way it is 4, this way it is 4. So, it will be a cuboid like that. Now, he wants us to find out the total surface area, total surface area of the cuboid, of the cuboid will be equal to, will be equal to, this I will take as L, this is width B. Now L into B, L into B, like that I get four faces, 4L into B plus 2, this one, B into H. B into H. Now, L is 4 into L. This way it is 4 into B. Length is 8. Sorry. Length is 8. This is L. This is width, that is 4. Plus 2 into B, that is this face and the bottom face. That will be 2 into 4 into 4. Now that will be 4 eights are 32. 32 into 4. 128 plus 4 fours are 16 plus 16 into 2, 32. That will be 160, I think. 2 plus 8 is 10. 160 square centimeters, right? Because it is given in, you can write like this or you can write centimeter square also. This is the total surface area of the cuboid that we get by joining two cubes of 4 centimeter each side. Now there is there are some more problems we'll take up. There is one more paper I have taken. In this, a medicine capsule, one problem is a medicine capsule is in shape of a cylinder, is in the shape of a cylinder with hemisphere stuck to each of its ends. The length of the entire capsule is 14 mm and the diameter of the capsule is 5 mm. Find its surface area. Find its surface area. So the sketch is given. Sketch is like this. The sketch is like this. These are two hemispherical ends. Now this whole length is from here to here, it is 14 mm, 14 millimeter. This is 5 millimeter. This is 5 millimeter. That is, it will be diameter. This is the diameter. Diameter of the capsule is 5 mm and the length is 14 mm. Now here, the central part is a cylinder. These two are hemispheres. If you add both of them, they become one sphere. And all dimensions are given in a millimeter. So we are going to get the volume, surface area in square centimeters. Now, here there are two parts. The surface area, total surface area is equal to curved surface area of cylinder plus surface area of sphere. Now length of this curved surface area of cylinder will be 2 pi r l. This is the formula for curved surface area. Plus for surface area of sphere, the formula is 4 pi r square. 4 pi r square. So both of them should be added. I'll take this also as r. Now here, the length of the cylinder part will be here it is 2.5 mm, here it is 2.5 mm, that is totally 5 mm is to be subtracted, so this will be 9 mm. This is L, and radius for both is 2.5 millimeters, that is half of the diameter, 2.5. So it will be 2 into 22 by 7, or you can take out, you can do any way you can do, 2 pi into R, R is 2.5, into L is 9, plus 4 into 22 by 7 into R square. R square will be 2.5 square. So you can do it. I think nothing will get cancelled here. 44 into 2.5, 88. Into 2.5 into 44 into 2.5 2.5 into 44 110 into 9 990. This will be 990 by 7, plus this will be 8.88 into 6.25. 2.5 square will be 6.25. 48 plus 4, 52. 55. This will be 550 by 7. So 7 is the LCM. 990 plus 55. 550. 14 plus 1, 15. Square millimeter. It will be millimeter square or square millimeter. This is the answer. This is the answer that you get. This is for 3 marks. Next, one more problem. In the same paper, it is in choice. Now, here, a right circular cone of height 30 centimeter. He has given the sketch. A right circular cone of height 30 centimeters, that is this vertical height, is 30 centimeter. This is A, B, C, P, Q. This he calls as R1, and this he calls as R2. R2, from here to here it is R2, from here to here it is R1. Now this entire height is this thing. This is H1. This height is H1. Now he says, a right circular cone of height 30 centimeter is cut and removed by a plane parallel to its base from the vertex. If the volume of the smaller cone obtained is 1/27th of the volume of the given cone, calculate the height of the remaining part of the cone. That is, I have to get this height, remaining part of the cone. Now, for this, again, what we have to do is, now, triangle ABC is similar to angle APQ, a triangle APQ, because the angle A is common to both the triangles, this angle is equal to this angle and this is right angle, so they will be similar. So R2 by R1, therefore R2 by R1 will be equal to R PQ by BC. I'll take it like this. PQ by BC must be equal to AB. Now PQ is R2 by BC is R1 is equal to AP. AP is 30 by H1. So R2 by R1 will be equal to 30 by H1. Now what he is telling is the volume of the part removed, that is, it will be volume will be pi R1 square into H1 divided by 3. This will be equal to the volume of the entire cone, that will be pi R2 square into 30 divided by 3. Pi R square H, that is also pi R square H by 3, into 1 by 27. Now 3 ones are, 3 tens are, it will go, or this 3, that 3 will go. Let this be like that. This is 30, this 3 and this 3 will go. Now here, 3 nines are 27, 3 tens are, and this is R2. So this pi will get cancelled. Now H1 will be equal to 10 by 9 R2 square by R1 square. R2 square by R1 square. Or R2 square by R1 square is equal to 9H1 by 10 R1 square. So here from here, R2 by R1, this will be 30 by H1, the whole square is equal to 9H1 by 10. So, 900, 30 square is 900 by H1 square will be equal to 9H1 by 10. So cross multiplying, you get 9H1 cube is equal to 9h1 cube is equal to 900 into 10. So 9 ones are 900s are. So h1 cube is equal to 1000. 100 into 10. So h1 will be cube root of 1000, that is 10 centimeters. 10 centimeters. I got this h1 as 10 centimeters. So therefore, the height of the remaining part, this part, BP. Now, BP is what he wants. BP is equal to AP minus h1. AP is 30 minus h1 is 10. So this will be equal to 20 centimeters. This height from here to here, it will be 20 centimeters. 20 cm. Right. We have to do some more problems. We'll finish here. I'll take up the next in the next video.